Text 31. Considering your specific duty as a Kshatriya, you should know that there is no better engagement for you than fighting on religious principles, and so there is no need for hesitation. Out of the four orders of social administration, the second order for the matter of good administration is called Kshatriya. Kshat means hurt. One who gives protection from harm is called Kshatriya. Triya means to give protection. The Kshatriyas are trained for killing in the forest. A Kshatriya would go into the forest and challenge a tiger face to face and fight with the tiger with his sword. When the tiger was killed, it would be offered the royal order of cremation. This system has been followed even up to the present day by the Kshatriya kings of Jaipur state. The Kshatriyas are specially trained for challenging and killing because religious violence is sometimes a necessary factor. Therefore, Kshatriyas are never meant for accepting directly the order of sannyas or renunciation. Non-violence in politics may be a diplomacy, but it is never a factor or principle. In the religious law books, it is stated, in the battlefield, a king or Kshatriya, while fighting another king envious of him, is eligible for achieving heavenly planets after death, as the Brahmas also attain the heavenly planets by sacrificing animals in the sacrificial fire. Therefore, killing on the battlefield on religious principles and killing animals in the sacrificial fire are not at all considered to be acts of violence, because everyone is benefited by the religious principles involved. The animal sacrificed gets a human life immediately without undergoing the gradual evolutionary process from one form to another, and the Kshatriya killed on the battlefield also attain the heavenly planets, as do the Brahmins who attain them by offering sacrifice. There are two kinds of swadharmas, or specific duties. As long as one is not liberated, one has to perform the duties of his particular body in accordance with religious principles in order to achieve liberation. When one is liberated, one's swadharm, specific duty, becomes spiritual and is not in the material bodily concept. In the bodily conception of life, there are specific duties for the Brahmins and Kshatriyas respectively, and such duties are unavoidable. Swadharma is ordained by the Lord, and this will be clarified in the fourth chapter. On the bodily plane, swadharma is called vanasvarama dharma, or man's stepping stone for spiritual understanding. Human civilization begins from the stage of vanasvarama dharma, or specific duties in terms of the specific modes of nature of the body obtained. Discharging one's specific duty in any field of action in accordance with the order of higher authorities serves to elevate one to a higher status of life.